This wise but strict commander only lived for 33 years, but he had enough time to create the greatest power the world had ever known. In 11 years of war, he never lost. Alexander the Great from Macedonia became the most famous conqueror of all time. Alexander was the son of the Macedonian king Philip II. Even as a child, he loved the poems that the Greek poet Homer wrote about heroes. Alexander also idolized Achilles, the hero of the Trojan War, and Hercules, the great athlete of Greek myth. At that time, Macedonia, which was located at the northern edge of Greece, tried in every possible way to embrace the Greek culture. The outstanding Greek philosopher Aristotle educated Alexander from the time he was 13. He taught the young man not only ethics and logic, but also endurance, character, and self-control. Alexander said that his father gave him life, and Aristotle taught him to live with dignity. After the mysterious murder of his father, the ruling Philip II, 20-year-old Alexander took the throne. After severely putting down the sudden resistance of Greeks, he destroyed the city of Thebes. Then he began to prepare for his campaign to conquer the East. Alexander worked to outdo his father in everything, and dreamed not only of conquering the powerful Persian Empire, but also of bringing the population of the entire known world under his authority. He said, "In the universe, there is an innumerable set of worlds, but I haven't conquered even one." In the spring of 334 BC, Alexander led an army of 40,000 across the Hellespont, now the Dardanelles Strait, and began to war against Persia. In the battles at the river Granicus and the city of Issus, the army of Persian King Darius III was defeated. The Persians lost their entire fleet of ships and surrendered the Mediterranean Sea to the Macedonians. Alexander proved to be the father of his soldiers. He cared for the wounded and ordered that the relatives of his slain soldiers be free from all taxes. The historian Plutarch wrote about how when Alexander began to attack the Phoenician city of Tyre, many of the people in the city dreamt that the statue of Apollo wanted to go over to the enemy side. Therefore, the inhabitants of Tyre tied ropes around the statue and nailed it to its pedestal, fearing that Apollo was on the side of Alexander and would go with him. Even though the statue remained faithful to the people of Tyre, Alexander took the city after a seven-month siege. This victory opened the way for Alexander to enter the Nile Valley. In thanks for freeing Egypt from Persian rule, the Egyptians proclaimed 24-year-old Alexander the son of the Egyptian god Amun and the Pharaoh. After conquering the Persian Empire, Alexander the Great moved to Bactria and Sogdiana, now the territory of Afghanistan and Central Asia. Legend has it that in order to become the full master of Asia, Alexander was given a puzzle by King Gordias to untie an extremely confusing knot. Alexander, without hesitation, took a sword in his hands and quickly split the knot. Since then, the expression to cut the Gordian knot has meant to solve a difficult problem quickly and courageously. To strengthen his authority in the lands he had conquered, Alexander founded more than 20 fortified cities. The history of the cities Herat and Kandahar in Afghanistan and Alexandria in Egypt began during the time of Alexander. In 11 years, Alexander with his army created a huge empire, stretching from India to Istria, today's Danube, from the Balkans to Lower Egypt. Alexander only turned back because his army was extremely tired. It took his army as long as 2 years to return from India to Babylon, the capital of his new and huge state. Alexander the Great reorganized what had been the Persian Empire. He called up the Persians to military service, involved the Persian nobles in ruling the state, and married Persian King Darius's daughter, Statira. Once Alexander made a great holiday, the so-called Wedding of the East and West. Under his order, several thousand Macedonian soldiers married Persian women in the same ceremony. Then Alexander the Great demanded that, in his honor, temples should be built in Greece, statues should be created, and the same honors should be granted to him as had been granted to his glorified ancestor, Hercules. The great Greek orator Demosthenes criticized this. This youth thirsts for altars, so let them be erected. What trivia! However, when Alexander wanted to have the Persian royal court ceremony in Greece, the Greeks refused to bow before him. Alexander ruthlessly punished those who were dissatisfied. Once, his foster brother named Cletus, who had rescued him at the Battle of Granicus, declared that all Macedonians had assisted Alexander in achieving his accomplishments. Upon hearing this, Alexander snatched a spear from a guard and killed his friend. Alexander the Great, wanting to surpass Hercules, dreamed of conquering Arabia and northern Africa and sailing out to the Mediterranean Sea through the Pillars of Hercules. But he would not live to carry out his grand plans. On June 10, 323 BC, the great commander died suddenly of malaria. The huge power which he created appeared to be unstable, and so his military leaders divided it. They distributed the Greek culture across Mesopotamia, Iran, Syria, Judea, and Egypt. Alexander the Great, from Macedonia, brought together the civilizations of Greece and the Middle East, and began the great period in Greek history known as the Hellenic Age.